Enter the HIMARS, the High Mobility Artillery Rocket System. You can think of it as kind of a little brother to the M-27. The HIMARS is a heavy truck chassis with an LLM, or loader launcher module, mounted on its back.
It has a lot of advantages and disadvantages compared to the M-270. Whereas the M-270 is a track vehicle, this is a wheel-based vehicle, and since it's a wheel vehicle, it's much lighter, but also has half the payload, which means you'll carry half the rockets or half the missiles as an M-270.
Heavy vehicles like the MLRS have to use tracks to disperse all of that weight. But since HIMARS is light enough for wheels, it can quickly be transported almost anywhere in the world on the C-130 aircraft. This means it can go along with light, highly mobile units, like the 82nd and 101st Airborne Division, to provide artillery support in quick attacks or for first response mission. So it's ready for action as soon as that plane touches down. And it only takes 3 men to operate HIMARS.
You have a driver who drives the vehicle and is responsible for basically the carrier piece. You have a gunner who's responsible for the LLM, and he punches in the fire control panel. And then you have your section chief who is overall responsible for the entire vehicle.
The HIMARS fires 6 of the same kind of rockets as its big brother, the M270 MLRS. They are GPS guided and have a range of about 20 miles. Each rocket carries a payload of 644 baseball-sized submunitions that disperse on impact and devastate the target area. The system is also capable of launching a single long-range tactical missile. But launching rockets can be a dangerous business. So, no fire mission can be carried out until the crew has taken the time to prepare the driver's compartment for the blast.
They have the louvers on the front, which go down to block the light from the rocket, because at night, I mean, it'll blind you. And there's blast shields on each side, and the hatch gets sealed, and then you pressurize the cab so that no rocket exhaust can go in there, because the inside of the cab, the pressure is higher than outside the cab, therefore the rocket exhaust won't penetrate.
Once the mission is complete, reloading is a snap.
How this vehicle is loaded is from the top with a crane. As you pull up to the reload vehicle, the crane will extend out, pull the pod that you just fired and set it on the ground, pull the one off the vehicle and set it back down inside the truck, and it's ready to fire. It takes us about 10 minutes to get that done.
With six-wheel drive, the HIMARS can handle just about any type of terrain, and the crew doesn't have to worry about flat tires, thanks to its run-flat system.
The run-flat system will continuously pump air into the flat tire, which will get you where you need to go to change that tire.
The HIMARS is still in early trials. Even so, problems have been rare.
The only thing that they've really run into, one was laid over on its side going through rough terrain. It does have a reload arm on the side of it that adds significant weight to that one side. I mean, we've had no accidents, no problems, no serious safety incidents at all.
Well, there might not be any serious safety issues for its crews, but I'm guessing that as the HIMARS rolls out in full strength over the next few years, it's fairly certain to create a few safety issues for the jokers on the receiving end of its rockets.